All right. Here's a fun nugget. Now sink your teeth into this big old porterhouse there, fatty. All right. So I get an email from my agent. He goes, I got a crazy gig. Just tell me no, and I'll tell these people to kill themselves. And I go, well, let me hear the gig. He goes, it's a wedding on Long Island, couple grand. I do 25 minutes. I'm like, what are you kidding? That's great. And he's like, I don't know. It's pretty far out. We don't want people thinking you'll work for this much money. And I want to be like, I've been working under the books for like $300 here and there. Like, I'll do any gig. You know, you put three digits, I'm in. So I was like, I'll just do it. I got the night off. I'll take it. As you do. It's a big purse. So he goes, all right, here you go. Here's the details. I'm like, oh, cool. It's a Tuesday. He's getting married. It's kind of flattering that he wants to have me at the wedding. It's a horrible idea, but I'll take the dough. So it's in Stony Brook, Long Island. You ever heard of this?
Yeah, I've been to Stony Brook.
Really?
That's where the school is.
Ah, yes, and the milk.
I think that, what's the school? Is it Stony Brook, the college? Yeah, Stony Brook.
I think it is.
I think I did a gig with Quinn there. I opened for him. He went to school there for like a month, and I think they kicked him right out.
He was a big, big alcoholic. Did you drive?
I drove him there, and I think they shot, what's that great fucking movie with...
Deer Hunter.
Black Swan.
Ah!
They shot the dressing room that we were in at Stony Brook. They shot Black Swan in there.
Wow. Well, all these black swans are getting shot.
I was sniffing all the chairs because I love Portman.
Oh, who doesn't? It's a hot Jew. But, all right, so I go, I'll figure it out. And he goes, they can't pick you up, obviously. They're at the wedding, and you're on your own. I go, I'll figure it out. It's probably the LIRR. I go to the Penn Station. I buy a ticket, and I get on the train. It's a Sunday night. There's nobody in Penn Station but me and the hobos. I get on the train, and, you kind of start going, you're looking at the board, and it says, like, Octonville, Brockton House, Dickless, Sin Valley, Queefville, or whatever. And you're like, I'm not seeing the one I need. I'm not seeing Stony Brook. So I go up to some weirdo guy who's drinking a Bud Heavy, and I'm like, hey, man, how do I get to Stony Brook? He goes, that's never good. He goes, you got to get off at the third one. Then you got to transfer to another train. You got to ride that four stops, then get on another train. I was like, what? It's three trains.
Oof.
So I'm already like, and you can't relax. Because you're like, is this Queefville? Is that Queefville? Is that Cunt House? What is this? You know, so you're all over the place. You finally get to one. And then you get to the station. And it's one of those stations where there's like six tracks. And you're like, is that the train I need? Or is that the train I need? You know, the door opens on both sides of the train.
Right. So, and it's brutal, too, because with tracks, you can't just walk over. You got to go upstairs, across, and then downstairs. So it's timely if that other train comes and you're on the wrong tracks.
Exactly. So I'm running up to each train, and like you pop in, and nobody wants to help you. It's New York. So I go, is this going to Stony Brook or Labia Town or Clittburg, whatever it is? And they're like, and you're like, you only have a few seconds before it moves. So I finally find a conductor, and I'm like, which one is Stony Brook? He goes, you got to ride that one to, you know, Fayetteville or whatever. And I'm like, all right. So I'm on the right one. That's 2 hours. Whatever it is, I finally figured it all out. It takes me like 4 hours to get out there. So I'm like, geez, I'm glad that's over. And I've been on the train for so long. I look at my phone. I'm going to a resort in the woods. Now, it's a 25-minute walk from the train station, or I can Uber. And I go, you know what? I've been sitting on my ass for 4 hours. I'm walking it. So okay. I'm in a full suit, going to a wedding, walking through the woods at 8 at night, and I'm like, this is crazy. What am I doing? I got a headphone in. It's chilly. I'm in a suit, walking down, nice shoes on. There's a cabin there, maybe another cabin over there. And before I know it, I look at my phone, 15 minutes more to go. I'm 10 feet, maybe 20 feet in the road. It's just me and a buck. I don't know, a three-pointer, a foot, two-footer, what do you call it? A three-point buck?
It depends.
Huge
on the
antlers,
points.
The whole thing.
Six-point, probably.
Six, maybe a sixer. And I'm just like, and he's looking at me, I'm looking at him, and he owns this turf. I'm on his turf. I'm the city douche in the suit. He's like, what are you doing here? And I'm doing like the, all right. You know, I'm trying to scare it because you see how squirrely these deer are. They hear a twig pop and they run. But it's not, he's not budging. He's got antlers.
Well, here's the thing, too. Sorry to interrupt, but
no,
we've all seen the videos and the Instagrams where they stand on their hind legs and kick the shit out of a guy.
Yes, exactly. It looked like a moose. So I'm just like, now I'm going like, woo, woo, woo. If you would have seen me out the window, I'm in a suit going, woo, woo, you know? And it's just going like, I was like, what are you doing? And I'm like, ah, now I'm getting loud. It won't move. And I'm like, well, now I've been doing this like a minute and a half, so it's getting a little weird. Like, is it going to charge me? Does it think I'm attacking? Is it threatened? Is it pissed? And I start kind of like doing this shit, like something like you know, we call it iffing. You if at somebody, and he's not moving. He's just confused. And then eventually I just go, ah, and it just goes, all right, and it walks away. Just walks into the woods.
God, that's
crazy.
So terrifying, because these animals, you can't communicate with them, and I'm talking about deer, you can't communicate with them, and they have the antlers, like, I mean, they can just go nuts, and you can't just go, listen, sir, let's
exactly.
talk about this, you know, I'm just trying to go to a show, you know, I'm a good person, you know,
right.
Like, whatever, and like I said, I mean, like, there are those videos of deer just, like, fist fighting guys, and they kick the fuck out of them.
Completely. And, you know, he could just ram me with the antlers and pick me up on it and then throw me over a cliff. I mean, the odds are endless. So he walks away, and then Party's like, well, is he just hiding? And then when I get up here, he's going to trample me or whatever. So I'm kind of walking uneasy. Finally, I start running a little bit because I'm like, I just want to get this walk over with. So I start kind of jogging. I get to this place. It's this beautiful Norman Rockwell scene of like a cabin with a little curl of smoke and music playing and a, you know, manicured lawn. It's beautiful. It's probably there from the 18 whatever. I get in there. It's one of those old inns, you know, where the ceiling's right here, the floors creak, and everything's pretty and wooden and worn in. And I was like, hey, I'm here for the wedding, and I can see the wedding in the distance. And the guy goes, Jesus, get over here, get over here. He's like, they don't want to see you until it's time for you to go on. I was like, oh, okay. So what do I do? And he's like, just go sit at the bar. So I go sit at the bar. It's like a beautiful oak bar, you know. You can tell George Washington got blown there, whatever it is. It's got a ton of history. And I see these two old guys at the bar just chatting. I'm Jeff. I'm Bill. You know, they're drinking scotch. The two old Long Island guys. I sit down. The bartender's like this good-looking 21-year-old kid, tall guy, full head of hair, kind of beefy. And he goes, Mark Norman? And I go, yeah. He goes, oh, my God, I'm a huge fan. I love Out to Lunch. Oh, my God. It was crazy. Like, the odds of this. I feel like I'm in the middle of nowhere. This guy knows me. It was like a life raft. Like, ah, thank God. So we start chatting. He's asked me all these comedy questions. I get a dinner. I'm eating the dinner. I'm listening to these old fogies go at it. This guy's chatting with me. It's kind of nice. It's like 8:30. I'm supposed to go on at 9:15. So I'm kind of like, all right, I guess I'm on soon. And then I look at the phone schedule. I look at the train schedule. The next train is at 10:25. And the one after that is at 1:25, which would mean I would get home at 5:25 because it's a 4-hour ride. So I got to get on that 10:25. So now I'm chatting. These two old guys start going at it. They almost get into blows because they're just fighting over sports stats, and they're just going nuts. Like, ah, McKeever had 28 hits. Fuck you. He's like, what are you, a fucking homo? He had 29. You know, they're going at it. And this guy's wife kind of starts splitting him up, and she goes, let's get out of here. And he's like, fine, let's go. And she goes, oh, and they're shit-faced. She goes, I lost my keys. Now the whole place is, every staff member is looking for her keys. They're nowhere to be found. They can't drive. He's got to get her an Uber. It's a whole thing. Finally, it's like 8:50, 9 o'clock. I'm supposed to go on at 9:15. Now it's 9:30. I'm doing a half hour.
Oh, God.
But I got to make the train. Now it's 9:45, and they finally go, come on in. I go in. It's like out of a movie. It's a ballroom. The bride and groom are in the middle of the floor at a table. There's brown tables over here, round tables over there. I just stand in the middle and I rotate. They're all confused. Like, who is this? What's going on? I got a cordless mic. The 1-2's guy is going, woo! You know that sound of like one guy digging it? Like, woo, yeah.
Do I?
So horrible. Even the wife's not into it. She's like, oh, let him do his dumb thing with his idiot, you know, comic guy. And, you know, I'm kind of bombing. I'm doing a little riffing. I'm talking about how bad it is. I get a couple people listening. It goes okay, but it's the longest 25 minutes of my life. I get off stage. I look at my phone. It's 10:10. I'm like, all right, if I get a ride, I can make it back to 10:25. That's 15, good 15 minutes. The walk was 20 minutes, so the drive will be like 5. So then he goes, we all got to take photos. I'm like, oh, geez, all right. So now we're taking photos, bridesmaids, grooms, the whole thing. Me and the groom, me and the bride. You know, we got the fashion, the photographer there, like the professional lady. And I now get one where I'm sitting on his lap. You know, we'll make it jokey. Now you sit on my lap. And I'm like, oh, yeah, all right. And he goes, you're hanging out, right? They never think about the ride home. Never. I'm like, they just want you there to show, do the show and all that. And he was a nice guy, but it doesn't cross people's brains. Like, you have to get back to your bedroom at some point.
Yeah, well, this is a thing with you and I talk about, is that people assume that we're lonely, which is not incorrect always, but people are like, you don't want to be on a train going home. What's at
right.
home? You want to be here.
Yes.
Like, they assume, like, we got party, we got drinks, we got food. There's no way you don't want to be here.
That's exactly right.
There's girls, there's everything. So I understand where they're coming from, but, you know, sometimes we want to go home.
Yeah, and I do want to be there. I want to have a drink. I want to eat, and I want to dance and all that. But, like, it is a factor that the train is going to be here, and if I'm not on it, I get home at 5 a.m. And I know that doesn't affect their lives, but it affects mine, and they just can't see that.
Sure. No, I mean, you know, it's their wedding, so they're not looking out for other people's shit. No one's like,
right.
We got to make sure, you know, Cantor doesn't fuck my aunt.
Yeah.
I'm over here, you know, twirling the night away. It's my big night, so
exactly.
Fuck you.
So... they go, so you're hanging out, you drinking? I go, oh, yeah. And he goes, all right. And I go, I'm going to go get a drink. I walk back to the bar. The old people are flipping out. You know, they're still fighting. They can't find the keys anywhere. They're drunks. And I go up to the bartender, the guy who knew me, and I go, crazy question. It's 10:19. The train is at 10:25. Is there any possible way I could make this train? And I'm already downtrodden. I'm assuming it's not going to happen. And he goes, I'll drive you. And he goes, Billy, watch my post. And he throws a bar rag to Billy. Billy's like 18. He was mopping. He's like, And we jump in this guy's truck, and he's hauling ass. He's a volunteer firefighter. He's got this
nice.
Huge red truck. We're whizzing down. I see the deer. I flip it off. Hey, you piece of shit, buck. And we keep going. I get to the train at like 10:24. I say, thank you. You're my hero. I shake his hand. We take some photos. And then I jump out of the truck and I hear, bing, 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 bing. You know that train sound? Ding, 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 ding. It's coming. I run up there and I look at the train and I'm like, wait a minute. Is that going to New York? Or is that going more into Long Island? And I'm like, what the hell is this? And then another train comes on the other side. So I'm like, it's one of these trains. And this guy runs up. Now he's on the platform and he goes, other side. And I just go, And I run, and I got to get to the stairs, and I do the crossover bridge, come back down, doors open, I jump in, take three trains home, made it home at like 2 a.m.
Oh, God.
It was
You're
wild.
Fucking Cary Grant.
I'm Batman. It was crazy. I'm driving the bus. I mean, in the suit, running through the train station. It was bananas. And they were probably going, oh, when's he coming back with that drink? But I was out of there.
Wow, thank God for the second gayman on the grassy knoll, because I mean, he saved your life, and thank God you didn't get on another train. You would have been out in the fucking Hamptons. You would have had to call Jerry, which could have been a fun story also.
I would have been in Montauk, you know, in a suit for 3 days.